Everybody, I want to talk a little bit today about icebergs. And the way this kind of came to my mind was yesterday I was getting my hair done, and Liz Tanzillo and I were talking about 9/11. And she was actually one of my students, my first year teaching, and that was in 2001. And we were reminiscing about where we were and, our thoughts and feelings when that happened. And she was telling me, from a teenager's perspective, how what she was thinking, and I was telling her from the teacher's perspective, what I was thinking. And I don't know, about you, where you were when it happened, but for me, it was kind of like the world just, teaching just kind of stopped. It was so traumatic. And how do you just like carry on? Okay, now we're going to work on adjectives and adverbs or something. I was teaching sophomore English then. And so teaching kind of stopped for me, but then what do, for your lesson plan or whatever? And that was really hard. And so as the day progressed, that it didn't feel right to carry on with teaching for me. I noticed that students were just sort of like, as the day progressed, they were just kind of like taking it like a great old free day and chit-chatting and laughing, having a good old time. And I got so angry. I couldn't understand how people could just be taking it so lightly and not be as devastated as I was. And so I really remember it was probably midway through the afternoon that I just finally like said, stop, everyone get out a piece of paper. And I just had them like journal write some kind of response of their feelings. And this is in a class where I had been frustrated with their behaviors because I thought they were really, what my mind perceived as inappropriate behavior for such a serious day. So I had them journal, right? And all of a sudden, all of these feelings started coming out. Students were, who had just previously been laughing and talking about what they were going to do on Saturday, were suddenly now talking about how they were afraid, how they were concerned about family, how they had relatives in the military, and they didn't know what this would mean for them. And all these emotions started pouring out. And that was a major lesson for me to realize that behavior is like an iceberg. You do not know what is going on in the hearts and the minds of your students. You see the tip of the iceberg, but you don't know, what else is going on under there. And you don't know if some of these behaviors you see on the top are coping strategies for the feelings and thoughts they have that are lying underneath. And so I think that in education, we need to have like a code word, like code word iceberg. When you're dealing with some really tough student behaviors or some low motivation, you need to be able to say in your own head and maybe to your colleagues and peers, okay, iceberg, I think we've got something else going on here that we cannot see that is affecting this student. Because if you look at students very one-dimensionally, you're going to miss everything else that's going on, and you're just going to lead yourself to more frustration, like I was on the day of 9/11. Once I got those feelings and thoughts out of them, that gave me a lot more empathy and understanding for them. And I knew that what I was seeing on the surface were coping mechanisms. And my students really were struggling just as much as I was. So, code word iceberg, there's a lot more that goes on that we cannot see. Have a wonderful day.